This week kicked off with the tragic news of the death of President Ebrahim Raisi and seven other Iran government officials on Sunday when the helicopter they were traveling in came down near the border with Azerbaijan. Messages of condolence flooded in throughout the week from Iran's allies around the region, including the Syrian government as well as Hamas and Hezbollah. Russia and China also sent their condolences, as did NATO, while the UN Security Council observed a minute's silence. Having been elected president in 2021, Raisi has enjoyed a good working relationship with Uganda. He last visited the country last July on a two-day state visit, where he held meetings with President Yoweri Museveni to improve political and trade cooperation. This was the first trip to Africa by an Iranian president in 11 years. While addressing the audience at the Iranian embassy in Kampala on Wednesday, President Museveni described Raisi as a unifier and a dedicated person. He assured Iran that the government would continue working with them for the betterment of the two countries.
When I heard the death of His Excellency Raisi, As I wrote in the book here, we have been dealing with Iranian leaders ever since we came into government. Now, when His Excellency visited us recently, I could see that he was a very dedicated person, but also a unifier. May his soul rest in eternal peace. Thank you very much.
On Thursday, massive crowds gathered for a funeral procession in the Iranian capital to pay their final respects to the president, whom officials and media dubbed a martyr. Millions were seen holding images of Raisi and waving flags lining the streets of Bijand for the procession of the coffin. He was laid to rest at the holy shrine of Imam Reza in his hometown of Mashhad. When the 5 days of public mourning ended, authorities, including acting president Mohamed Mokba, are now focused on organizing an election for a new president set for June 28th. A presidential election in Iran had not been expected until next year, and the crash has caused some uncertainty as to who will succeed Raisi, with some expressing concern about the upcoming president. The week commenced with the National Unity Platform preparations for the second phase of its nationwide mobilization tours, which kicked off on Wednesday. This is in preparation for the 2026 June election, in which new party president Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, commonly known as Bobi Wine, will contest as a presidential candidate in a second attempt to oust President Museveni. On Wednesday, Kyagulanyi set off for Kamuli from new party headquarters in Makere Kavule, Kampala, in company of Party Secretary General David Louis Rubongoya, Deputy President for Northern Uganda, Dr. Lina Zedriga, Mitiana Municipality MP Francis Zake, among other party leaders. At the Nile Bridge in Jinja, police halted Kyagulanyi and his large group of supporters. A standoff followed, which ended when police used tear gas to disperse the crowd. Kyagulanyi was allowed through the bridge without crowds of his supporters. He, however, was not allowed to reach the venue in Kamuli as police blocked the road with its truck, forcing him to make a U-turn. According to Busoga North Police Region spokesperson Mike Kasada, a rowdy, disorderly crowd were intercepted and dispersed between the border of Kamuli and Jinja district before they turned and went back. 10 suspects were arrested for inciting violence and defiantly organizing the political activity. The police spokesperson Fred Enanga on Monday said the law enforcement agency had not given a green light to NUP nationwide mobilization exercise. NUP Secretary Regional David Louis Rubongoya has written to the Inspector General of Police protesting the disruption of their mobilization tours, citing what he termed as unlawful actions of police and military, which infringes on their freedom of assembly as guaranteed under Article 29 of the Constitution.
See, the issue is that we notified you people already. So it's not that we are coming to notify. We are just here to protest about what happened yesterday.
So let's go in with you and maybe have this discussion even out from here. And then we'll see how we conclude.
On Saturday last week, the National Platform released a timetable for the countrywide tour, which was supposed to start in Kamuli on Wednesday, 22nd May 2024. It remains to be seen if National Unit Platform and nationwide mobilization tours will be permitted for the subsequent plans or police. NUP clash will continue to evoke memories of the 2021 election violence. The police spokesperson, Freddie Nang, on Monday said the law enforcement agency had not given a green light to NUP nationwide mobilization. With only 1 week left, Christians are gearing up for the much-anticipated Uganda Matters Day, which is celebrated annually on June 3rd at the Namugongo site in Wakiso. This week was dotted with pilgrims making progress on their holy trek, undeterred by the relentless harsh weather conditions and long distances. The largest group so far is the Nebbi Catholic Diocese, which has spent more than a week on their journey of faith. The 724-man group has so far gone through two sub-regions, West Nile and Bunyoro. They are now in Buganda sub-region. In other parts of the country, 115 pilgrims from North Kigezi, Chinyasa, Morukunjiri set off for Namugongo last week. About 800 pilgrims from Lira Diocese also set off for the religious trek, joined by 36 children aged below 12 years. 162 pilgrims from the Masindi Chitara Diocese also started their pilgrimage yesterday. It has not been an all-inclusive exercise with pilgrims living with disabilities joining the walk of faith.
I'm feeling okay. There is no anything like pain or muscles.
The spotlight is set on 32-year-old Eric Mungu Jabero from Chiriandongo, who, despite being confined to his tricycle, has pedaled with dignity. It has also been a beehive of activities at the Matters Shrine in Namugongo, as both the Catholic and Anglican sites start receiving pilgrims ahead of the celebrations. At the Anglican site, the six dioceses under the Rwenzori cluster pace towards final preparations to successfully animate the celebrations. Nebbi Catholic Diocese will animate the celebrations at the Catholic site this year.